In order to get you guys back up to speed, I'm gonna give you a quick rundown of what I've been up to. So I think the last time I left you off, let's just look back like at the last like episode. Let me get you caught up in the cars. So, I used to have a 37 Ford, and I say used to because I sold it.
Brad, where's Brad?
Brad and I are gonna go for a road trip. So a while back I talked about selling my 37 Ford. It's happening, today's the day. And I ended up with this guy. And kind of made a decision. 37's going away, and I'm coming home with a Model A. 31 Model A Roadster, and you can see that I kind of got the motor out of it, and it's not how it came, not in that condition anyway. It was a running driving car until I pulled the motor out of it, and that's kind of, I guess, what we're going to be working on today. I'll show you where it's at. Maybe I should like do one of these, like, here's where it's at today. So it had a knock when I got it. So I tightened up the number 3 rod, number 4 rod, because that was where the noise seemed to be coming from when they were shorted out. Didn't quite solve the problem, so I pulled the motor, and this is what I found.
Yeah, the connecting rod shouldn't rock on the pin like that. I'm thinking that the pin bushing is just a little shot.
This is a full-size wrist pin bushing on a Model A. This is the wrist pin bushing that I pulled out of number 3. Two pieces, and they're each like 5 thousandths thick. So the reason this engine is in the shape it is in is because of this.
Look at all that sludge. It's like a sludge. Ugh. That's a good 3/4 of an inch thick. It's insane.
Now, not really a good thing. With old cars, you always gotta be able to like read through the BS. You know, everyone's always, you go and you buy an old car and they're like, this engine's been rebuilt, or somebody's been through this thing, or it's had a, you know, most of that stuff is just garbage. I feel like I'm a little rusty. Like, I don't know how to even talk to the camera because it feels awkward. Shouldn't feel awkward. I've only like done this whole video thing for like over a year. I should be comfortable with it. This motor here, it was never sold to me as like, this is a great running car. It was sold to me as like, yeah, I got the thing running and then it quit. Needed some work done to the thing. Well, the things that cause that sludge buildup, if you're not familiar with how oils work, today, modern oils, they have a thing called a detergent in it. And the detergent collects all the like carbon and all the dirt and things that just happen to get inside of engines as they're running. And it bonds to those pieces of dirt. But if you don't maintain the equipment, well, that sludge builds up and builds up and builds up, leads to engine failure. With that being said, let's get to that. Other than I have to finish my to gouge out. I mean, the thing is like barn find. I mean, it really is a barn find. And the fact that it's a 31 Roadster, that's even pretty cool because a lot of people really like Model A Roadsters. The basic outline for this Roadster is I'm going to make what they call like a traditional hot rod, but I'm going to keep the stock Model A 4-cylinder motor. In order to, for me to feel comfortable on selling a car, I like to know that they run good, that I can jump in the car and go somewhere and not really worry about it breaking down. And that motor in the condition that it was, it wasn't gonna happen. So once I get the motor fixed up, do some just little things. I mean, right now, aesthetically, I've done quite a bit to the car. A big and little rubber tire combination. So it's got like 750 16s in the rear, and it's got 550 16s in the front. I've chopped the windshield 2 inches. What other things? It's gonna get a 32 shell. I've dropped the headlamp bar. You know, basically I'm just kind of making it, trying to look like that 1940s, you know, traditional hot rod. I guess is the word, that traditional, or trying to make it look like something, you know, some slick back, greasy haired looking kid. I mean, you know, would like to drive, you know, coming out of World War II. I really don't know what the end game is with this car is. Like I said, I plan on, like, I really hope to, once it gets up and driving, to kind of just pass it along and let somebody else, you know, do all the finishing touches on it. All right, well, that's what I've been up to. You guys take it easy. I'll catch you next time around.